right, so I know you're like, dude, this kind of music doesn't have guitar in it. Yeah, it does. And if you don't like it, don't thumbs down it. Just don't watch it. Pah. I'm just kidding. So anyways, this has actually got a cool little guitar part in it. I listen to the song, I'm like, that's, you know, that's pretty cool. We got all, you know, arpeggiated picking, which just means, you know, single note picking per given chord. Two different types of, you know, verse and rhythm patterns and chorus and blah, blah, blah. So you get a kind of a cool, you know, right hand workout in this tune. Never discount any genre of music. There's always something to learn in guitar land. Which brings me to, if you got a request, link below will set you free. It'll just give you winning lotto numbers and all sorts of good stuff. So anyways, let's zoom in and get to this. That's the whole song, we're done here. No, really, that's really it. It's only one set of chords. We got A minor, F, C, and G. That's it. Now, the only thing that's different is there's a picking pattern on one, and then there's two different strumming patterns, whether you're in the verse or the chorus. So the intro picking pattern, also, I think it is the pre-chorus of the song, is the same picking pattern on the bottom three strings, just the top note moves around depending on which chord you're on, which root note you have to hit. So, for instance, on the A minor, we're gonna go A, D, B, G. Now, an A minor chord is just first finger, first fret, B string. These two guys are in the second fret, and it's gonna be on the D and the G string, and you hit from the A string down. Now the next chord is an F chord. You can do it bar from the first fret E to E, and then the second finger is gonna be on the G string second fret. These two guys, ring and pinky, are going to be on the third fret of the A and the D. Now, I'm doing this chord like this. I use my thumb, and I'm only gonna be worried about the D, G, and B strings anyway, so I cheat. So there you have it, I'm a cheater. So next, we got the C chord, and it's gonna have the same picking pattern as the first one, which is gonna be A, D, B, G. Now you're gonna have your third finger, third fret A, second finger, second fret D, first finger, first fret B, same picking pattern. Then we're gonna go up to a G chord. Now all you really need to worry about for this particular part is fingers 2 and 3, both on the third fret, E and B. Now, no one's gonna, chord foul, 10-yard penalty. No one's gonna care, right? So you can just do that. Now the traditional G chord would be more like this, which we will use in another part of the song. So, anyways, the beginning, the intro, real basic, right? Now what you want to make sure, the only thing you got to kind of watch out for is between the F and the C chord. Keep fingers 1 and 2 down and then actually move your third finger and then start it before you move up your next finger. Because you want the B and the G to ring out. Other than that, that's it. The next part is going to be two downstrokes. So on the A minor and the C, we're gonna just do two downstrokes. The next two chords or chords 2 and 4 are gonna have the same pattern as well. So it's gonna be on the F and G. So I just went up, up, down, down, up. we got. You're only going to do that twice, which gets us into the verse. Now, the only difference in the verse is going to be the different strum pattern. So that's going to be. So again, chords 1 and 3, same pattern. 2 and 4, same pattern. 1 and 3 is going to be. You probably need me to do that one again because that's a tough one. One more time. All right, you did it. Woo! And then we're just going to do up, up, down for the next, you know, chords 2 and 4. And then back into. Fumble! But anyways, I think it just does that 4 times as like a pre-chorus to each chorus. That's the whole tune. I mean, you did it again. Again, awesome job. You know, picking. Even if you just went up and down each chord, it's a great exercise. You know, people think of, oh man, there's no guitar in this kind of music or whatever, but oftentimes there's a cool guitar part that you can always learn to better your chops. So don't discount any genre of music just because you don't think it has guitar in it. That's a cool guitar part, man. It works. Always use it to get better, any type of music. So anyways, good job out there.